In this lesson, I'm going to go into a lab and show you how to use the AWS SAM in a really simple way. So what we're going to do is actually use some of the templates available. And to do that, we're going to use these commands. So we're not running the SAM package and SAM deploy yet, which is probably the most common way you're going to use it in any real world scenario. But we're just going to do this to get some hands on and look at some of the options available to us. So we're going to run SAM init, SAM build, and then SAM deploy. And when we run SAM build, what's going to happen is AWS SAM is actually going to automatically upload the information to the S3 bucket for us. And then when we run SAM deploy, it will deploy our AWS CloudFormation stack and a change set, and we'll have a Lambda function with an API ready to run. The other thing we can do on our development terminal is run SAM local invoke to invoke the function in a local test environment. And this is where SAM will download and run a Docker container locally. And you can also do this for the API, so we'll see how that works. So I'm going to head over to a terminal window and start using AWS SAM. So I'm in the terminal, and the first command that I'm going to run is SAM init. And then what happens is I get presented with this option where I can choose to use one of the quick start templates. So I'm going to select one. I can then choose my runtime. I'm going to choose one, so that's Node.js 12. And then we get the option to give our project a name. So let's just call this SAM app test. And we can see it's now cloning some templates from GitHub, and it's generated our application of this name, and it's of the Node.js runtime type. And what it's going to do is deploy a simple Hello World application. So I should now be able to change into a directory that it's created for me. And I'm going to clear the screen and get this down to the middle for you. So let's have a look in that directory. So we have a template.yaml, we have a Hello World directory, and then we have a README and an events directory. So let's quickly have a look at what this template.yaml file looks like. So I'm going to go to the directory, sample app test, and let's just have a look at this YAML file. So we can see that in this file, we've got a transform header. So we know that this is an AWS SAM template. It's also a YAML file. And then if we come down, we'll see our resources being declared. So we have resources, Hello World function, got a type, and it's the AWS serverless function type. We've got a code URI, so that's where our code is in the Hello World directory. We've got the Lambda handler and runtime. And then in the events here, this is where we're specifying an API. So it's going to create an API called Hello World. It's going to have a resource path of /hello, and it's going to use a get method. And that's how simple it is. So the main resources are created in just this tiny amount of code. So we've got a serverless function, and we've got a serverless API. And then down here, we've got some outputs. So we'll get the gateway endpoint URL, the function ARN, and the Hello World function role ARN. So that's all quite simple. Let's go back to our command line. And the next thing I'm going to run is SAM build. So this is going to build the resource locally. And it tells me it's created some build artifacts and a build template. And we can now run these commands. So this is what we use if we want to be able to check our functions locally. So I can run SAM local invoke and then put in Hello World function and hit enter. And it says it's invoking the app.lambda handler. And we can see now that it's fetching a Docker container image. It's going to mount that image in a certain path, and then we're going to be able to run the code in that container. So that's it. You see, we just got a response from our Hello World function, but we haven't even deployed it up to AWS yet. We can also do the same for our API. And in fact, again, I'll clear the screen and bring this down to the middle for you. And let's do SAM local start dash API. So this is mounting the Hello World function at, and that's obviously a local loopback address on port 3000. And it says we can now browse to the above endpoints to invoke our functions. So I can use this URL. Let's copy that URL, and I'm going to paste it into a browser window. And again, we get our Hello World. So that's our function and our API working together locally on my computer. So that shows you how you can use AWS SAM to test your code locally. So let's go back to the command prompt. I'm just going to stop this function. Let's clear the screen again, bring it down. And now we're ready to deploy. So let's do SAM deploy. And I'm going to use what's called guided mode. So we put dash dash guided. And so it's going to ask me what the stack name is. So let's just call that SAM app test as well. It's going to ask me for the region. I'm going to put in AP Southeast 2. And then I'm going to leave the defaults here. You can choose whether you want to confirm changes and allow SAM to automatically create any IAM roles that are needed. So that's it. The deployment is initiating and we can see that it's creating a change set. So let's have a look in CloudFormation. Back in CloudFormation, we can see we have this SAM app test with a create in progress. Let's have a look at events. You can see it's creating a REST API, a hello world function, and some roles. And if we head over to outputs, we can see that we've got our hello world API output. So let's open this in another window. And there we go, we get hello world. So we've just deployed our API gateway API and our Lambda function just by running a few commands. So now that we've done that, that's all I wanted to show you in this lab. And we can quite easily get rid of our stack by running the command AWS CloudFormation delete stack. And then we're going to give it the stack name, which in this case was SAM app test. And in some cases, you might have to specify your region, but I don't need to because I know this is in the same region I'm working in. So going back into CloudFormation, we should now see a delete in progress for our stack. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. That's just a really easy way of deploying a serverless application. And in the next lesson, we're going to have another lab. And in that, we're going to use the SAM package and SAM deploy commands.